Chinese history is generally divided into periods based upon the dynasty, or ruling family, that governed China at that time. From 1027 BC to 220 AD, China was ruled by three main dynasties. First is the Zhou Dynasty, 1027 BC to 221 BC. In 1027 BC, the Shang were conquered, marking the beginning of the Zhou Dynasty. The new Zhou ruler justified his rule as the mandate of heaven. The Chinese believed that their ruler was chosen to rule by heaven and that heaven would also overthrow a bad ruler. Scholars taught that if a ruler became selfish and thought of himself first before the people, then heaven would bring floods, riots, and revolts to end his reign. Then a new ruling family would emerge. Later Chinese rulers continued this mandate as the basis for their authority to rule. Let's take a look at the dynastic cycle in China graphic. At the top, we see strong dynasty establishes peace and prosperity. It is considered to have the mandate of heaven. Down to the right, in time, dynasty declines and becomes corrupt. Taxes are raised and power grows weaker. Disasters such as flood, famines, peasant revolts, and invasions occur. Old dynasty is seen as having lost the mandate of heaven, and rebellion seems justified. Dynasty is overthrown through rebellion and bloodshed. A new dynasty emerges. The new dynasty gains power, restores peace and order, and claims to have the mandate of heaven. And so the cycle repeats. Zhou rulers established a system in which land was given to nobles in exchange for military service. During succeeding centuries, Zhou rulers conquered neighboring peoples and made them part of China. However, by the 6th century BC, local nobles became too powerful for the Zhou rulers to control, and China was plunged into civil war. The greatest legacy of the Zhou dynasty was the work of two Chinese philosophers, Confucius and Laozi. These philosophers were deeply affected by the turmoil they lived through at the end of the Zhou dynasty. Confucius sought to bring order to China's social and political life, while Laozi was more interested in peace and inner stability for individuals. Qin Dynasty, 221 BC to 206 BC. Shi Huangdi, the Lord of Qin, was a provincial ruler who unified all of China through conquest. He began a new dynasty and became the first Chinese ruler to call himself emperor. He felt that all power should rest in the hands of a single absolute ruler. Shi believed that people were not necessarily good and that they needed a strong government to punish those who committed bad acts. His rule was very harsh. He rejected Confucianism, burnt Confucius books, and persecuted scholars. Shi's accomplishments. Shi Huangdi centralized power by dividing China into districts, each with its own military and civil administrator. Construction of a network of roads and canals was begun to unite distant parts of China. Uniform systems of writing and measurements were established throughout the empire. Shi also joined together several existing protective walls to form the Great Wall of China in order to protect his empire from nomadic peoples to the northwest. Stretching 1,500 miles, it stood 22 feet high and 15 feet thick, taking thousands of laborers many years to complete. Shi also had workers build an immense army of clay soldiers to surround him in his tomb. Although Shi's rule was short, he had lasting effects in creating a unified and centralized China. Han Dynasty, 206 BCE to 220 CE. Following the Qin Emperor's death, the people rebelled against his harsh style of rule. After several years of civil war, a new dynasty emerged. The Han Emperors kept China united for over 400 years. The Han are credited with inventing paper and lead-glazed ceramics and with advances in silk weaving. In addition, the Han emperors established examinations to select candidates for imperial service. candidates were tested on their knowledge of history and Confucian philosophy. This encouraged the spread of Confucian ideas. The examination system also strengthened the power of the emperor by weakening the independence of the nobles. They could no longer claim the high status and rewards of imperial service as a matter of right. Only those who passed these rigorous tests could assist the emperor in the government. Examinations provided a way for commoners to move up the social ladder. Confucian ideals came to unite all government officials and the Chinese upper classes as a whole. The Han rulers established overland trade routes, such as the Silk Road, which connected China to the Roman Empire and other regions. Merchants carried goods by camel caravan along this route through mountains, steppes, and deserts, with resting points in new towns along the way. Over these routes, China exported its silk, iron, and bronze in exchange for gold, linen cloth, glass, ivory, animal hides, horses, and cattle. India also introduced Buddhism, which became popular in China. The fall of the Han Dynasty. The Han Dynasty ruled for over an immense territory for 400 years, nearly twice as long as the history of the United States from its independence to the present. Towards the end of this period, the Han emperors were weakened by a series of rebellions against their authority. To crush these rebellions, the imperial government gave more power to provincial governors, including the ability to tax and raise their own local armies. Some governors used this newfound power to become local warlord. Economic hardship from population growth led to a rise in banditry in the countryside. In 221 AD, the last Han emperor turned his power over to an independent warlord. Han China finally collapsed into a series of civil wars and split apart into a series of separate states.